right now we're on the cusp of delivering on a promise which we've heard about for a long time.
We're seeing therapies now that we only dreamed about 20 years ago or 10 years ago.
The future looks very promising. The Eye Institute launched the Audacious Goals Initiative. We wanted to develop a moonshot project that would have major impact on restoring vision. We began by calling together several hundred vision scientists, and we placed before them the task of developing an ambitious target. What they responded with was the idea of restoring vision to the eye that had lost cells. Primary examples are photoreceptor cells and retinal ganglion cells. The NEI Audacious Goals Initiative is developing regenerative medicine to restore these cells and to restore vision, at least partially, for people who have already lost some of their sight.
I've spent my entire adult life working on the visual system, in particular the retinal ganglion cells, or the cells that connect the eye to the brain. The work that we're doing specifically for the AGI effort is to try and understand how retinal ganglion cells can be regenerated after injury. We're asking whether or not neural activity and gene therapy and growth factor therapy can be used in humans in order to save retinal ganglion cells that are sick and that might otherwise die, as well as to regenerate connections between the eye and the brain. And the way we're doing that in particular is using tools like virtual reality to trigger the activity of the ganglion cells, and very specific ganglion cells, in particular the ones that are sick, to see whether or not that can recreate connections with the brain that are lost or are slowly dying back. In the last 10 years in particular, there's been an absolute explosion of new and exciting techniques brought into study of the nervous system, in particular the visual system.
Let me give you one example, gene therapy. Gene therapy, of course, is replacing the mutated gene by a normal gene.
A gene can be introduced to the eye by packaging it in a virus. Typically, we think of viruses as a bad thing, cold virus, flu virus, because they make us feel bad, but there's some viruses which can carry cargo with it. In the laboratory, one can construct one of these viruses with any kind of cargo that you want. A cargo for, say, growth, to keep cells that are sick in the eye from disappearing and shrinking. And so you can take that virus with this cargo, this cell growth gene, if you will, inject into the eye, and then some of the cells within the eye will get infected by the virus, but again, to make them healthier, not to make them sicker.
Gene therapy is not just theoretical. It is actually being used to treat eye disease in children. The breakthrough came in 2008 when gene therapy was successful for treating childhood blindness termed labor congenital amaurosis, or LCA. This treatment reinvigorated the entire field of gene therapy for all of medicine. What we learned through vision research can now be extended to many diseases beyond the eye alone.
Really exciting to think about the eye and the Eye Institute funded programs as one of the first places where gene therapy is actually being applied in humans.
NEI funded researchers work at the NIH and at institutions across the country. They advance discoveries, technologies, and treatments to address blinding diseases, while they also create jobs and contribute to their local economy.
Before AGI, there were different labs doing their own things. There were some labs doing basic science research. There were some labs trying to translate into clinic. But I think what AGI did is brought them all together. Breakthroughs happened definitely at the crossroads of different disciplines. I think you could not do any of these things if you did not merge different disciplines. My specific research is that we're trying to treat the disease called age-related macular degeneration.
Age-related macular degeneration, or AMD, significantly reduces the vision of millions of individuals.
AMD causes the retinal pigment epithelium cells inside the back of the eye to die. In turn, this causes subsequent loss of central vision, vision for driving and for reading. KAPIL BHARTI is working with adult-derived stem cells.
Prepared from the patient's own skin or blood.
So what we have done in the lab is, it started off with work from many other labs around the world that take patient-specific iPS cells and use stem cells and convert them into this layer of cells, the pigment epithelium, in the lab, grow it as a tissue, and take this entire tissue and put it back into the patient's eye before the photoreceptors die off. with the hope that that transplanted epithelium would support now the photoreceptors and protect them from dying.
This is a very promising approach and tended to slow or reverse the progress of this disease. And a clinical trial is expected to begin early next year, 2018.
So I would definitely say it's hopeful time for those patients, and we're gonna bring them a therapy that they really, really need.
There are many interesting and important advances that are currently in progress. All of these efforts together hold great promise for improving public health and providing safe and therapeutically beneficial interventions against the diseases that annually affect millions of people.